Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, back with another plastic kit review. This one is another one of the goofy kits I like showing you guys. I just picked this up recently off eBay, and this is the Lindbergh Transparent Roswell Alien. As you know, I showed you some other stuff from Lindbergh previously, especially this model ship right here, and I picked that one up off Tower Hobbies. This one I got on eBay, and I got it for a steal. You can already see by the size of the box that this is a big, big kit, and let's just go top to bottom on that thing. That is a giant size kit. The box itself is about 20 inches tall. And inside the box is a huge figure kit. I was able to score this kit, I joke you not, I wouldn't joke about this, 99 cents on eBay as a new in the box kit. When I got it, it was still sealed in plastic and the tabs were all still taped shut on the box. It was an absolute bargain. Even shipping was nice and low. I can show you guys right there. I'm not making anything up. 99 cents for the kit, $8.70 shipping. I paid $9.69 for it. It comes with the clear body, it comes with the organs, the bones, and a display stand. The only thing I discovered when I opened the brand new box, cut the shrink wrap off, and took all the parts out, counted everything up, was that unfortunately, whoever at Lindbergh, way back when this was boxed, and this was boxed pre-2008, never put this stand in. And that's kind of a bummer, but at the price I paid for the kit, I can go take a piece of 1x6 off the shelf in the garage that I use for lumber, and I can put it on the table saw and the bandsaw, cut it into a circle, use some spackle, make a rough finish on the base, and cut two holes and stick the feet in. It won't be a big deal. So I'm still coming out way ahead. I think the average price on these things is anywhere from $20 to $40, depending on the seller. And then you got to add shipping into that at some point. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box. Like I said, this is a huge box. Beautiful on the outside. Shows you everything you're going to get front and back on it. And that's exactly what it looks like when you take it out. So we'll move this to the back, and we'll start looking at all the cool stuff that's in the box. Of course, one of the first things we're going to see here is going to be the destructions. And those are standard Lindbergh black and white. This thing assembles really, really easy. There's nothing much to it. It's all going to be detail painting, if you wish. You can see all the parts, we counted out all these parts, everything's here except for this cool looking plastic base, which I can replicate in wood and some spackle and painting to make it look like the black base with the green flecks of glitter. The base that would have been here wouldn't have had any coloring on it anyways, it would have just been black plastic. So that's not a huge loss, but it did have everything else. It assembles quite easily. All the bones are two-piece. Now, you can put this together just as it is and glue it together with regular model cement and snap it all in the clear plastic body and be done with it. Or you can do some detail painting to bring it out. What I'm probably going to do is put the bones together, fill the seam, and then just spray them with craft paint in a bone color just so that they look a little, you know, a little better. Just take the seam off of it. Nothing very fancy. And we'll be doing some detail painting on some other parts as I show you guys in a second. You can see everything goes in. The bones all go in. Then the organs go in. This is identical to building the Visible Man or Visible Woman. This is just gigantic and it's an alien figure. So it's kind of fun to have on display in the house or in the office. And a little bit of advertising on the back there. We've got some nice off-white plastic parts, and these are all going to get repainted by me in a more flat color so they're not so glossy. But we can go through all the parts on the trees here. They're very cool, and they're very thick plastic. You can see the alien skull there. Nicely detailed. They're so big that they really didn't have to, you know, it's not like there's a lot of super fine detail in a skull anyways. They got that looking real nice as their interpretation of an alien. You've got a lower jaw there. You've got the rib cage, and you've got the back of the rib cage with the spinal column and the hip bones right there. And you can sing the song as you put it all together. So these, just as they are right here, just need a little bit of cleanup on some of these parts here. Just these ejector pin marks. And, you know, you wouldn't even have to fill them, just sand them down and then spray it with some craft paint to give the bones a flat color, as which I would prefer. I don't think they should be shiny. In just my opinion. I don't know much about aliens, but I have seen real bones, and when they're not in the person, they aren't shiny. So these are the rest of the white plastic pieces, or the off-white plastic pieces. You can see the bones all key together easily into each other. Large pins, and then you'll just have to clean up small seams on the edges. But since there's no real intricate detail on any of these parts here, the seams will be super, super easy to clean up. And that's why, you know, you could even use like whiteout or just the cheap tester's putty if you just wanted to use that and just shove it in with your finger real quick and it's going to come out. You could even use melted plastic, you know, mixing it with glue and styrene filler glue. You could use some of that if you wanted. It's going to take very minimal work. This is the back of his giant skull. This looks like it would be a rib cage, but this is actually the back of his head. And that will go in like this and line up. Like so with those big pins, so that it encases his giant brain and his huge goggly eyes. You got the leg bones, arm bones, the hands and the feet are all one piece, thankfully. Molded very nicely. You can see those big hands stretching out. I'm going to grab you. And the little tiny feet. And they're just accessory doodads and bebops to snap it back together. Make it, you know, complete a seam and stuff like that. So that's all for the white plastic parts. I was surprised because in all the... Oh, I got stuff falling off here. On the box, it says, you know, that the following colors are recommended if you wish to paint the transparent model kit gold, white, yellow, red, blue, and brown, and paint not included. But when you open the box, that's not really the way it is, because when you open the box... Everything has been molded in a color. All the organs, the eyeballs are done, which is great. I'm glad the eyes are done. I hate doing eyes on figures. And those are done. But all the organs are molded in a couple different colors. And you can identify a lot of these. I'm not an anatomy expert. And I certainly don't know a lot about alien anatomy. but you can see, you know, you've got obvious things like the lungs and the trachea. These two parts, these two big parts here... actually go together with these pins. You can see it's very, very soft plastic. They go together with these pins and form his huge brain. And then from the inside, you can see one is small, one is big, and that lets you know which of his big goggly eyes to put in there. And then you put one eye in here and one eye in here from the back, and that's what makes up your goofy-looking skull there with his eyes staring at you. You know, one eye's bugging out. One eye looks somewhat normal. These won't require any work at all if you just wanted to assemble the kit the way it was. You wouldn't have to do anything but get out a little bit of glue on this kit and put it together. But if you want, I think, you know, after you put the eyes in and you join the brain halves together, and regular model cement wouldn't work for this. I would use something like shoe goo. You've all heard of that. It's a very flexible silicone to hold these together. Because these are going to flex, and you can take the alien apart after it's assembled, and you can, you know, make it squish, whatever kids want to play with it, whatever they want to do. So, and then it's got certain different parts like these pinholes and locator areas so that you can snap all the organs into all the right places inside. But once you did that, you could take some gloss craft paint, because I think the organs should be a little shiny, and or you could just use flat craft paint too. And, you know, like, I don't even know what the hell this is. You know, like this is his intestines and stuff. And if you don't like the kit, you could go fishing, because that's a pretty cool plastic worm looking thing. So, you know, this would probably be like his heart or something. And, you know, all different kinds of organs that all interlock into each other. So it is kind of neat. They're all rubbery, you know, kind of like a flex vinyl or something. So they would take craft paint just fine. Don't paint it with enamels or they'll never dry. You could put that all together and then give everything like a wash or, you know, a dry brushing to just bring out some of the folds and the details, especially the lungs, you know, stuff like that. And then I would clear coat it with a high gloss, because I think that would look cool if the organs were shiny inside, like they were wet and gooey and sticky. So you could do whatever you want, or you could just give it to a kid and let them assemble it just the way it is. I'm going to put a wash on them and then gloss coat it so that I can snap it all together inside and squish it all in there. And so that's all up to you, but those are the interior parts. And that's just really neat. Like I said, think of the price I paid for it. So even though it's missing the base, I still got a deal. The last part in the kit, we're going to have to go back up to show you that the clear skeleton, this clear skin, is the same size as the box. Look at that monstrosity. And they painted all the veins on there for you. So why the box keeps mentioning paint and all that stuff instead of just glue? I don't know. Maybe originally when they marketed it, you had to do this all yourself. But now it's all done for you. And I'm kind of glad because those veins would have been a real bear to paint on the inside. So just like the Visible Man, Visible Woman, this is just a giant version that's a fake alien. And we can set him down here so you can get a look. He is 19 inches tall from the top of his giant melon all the way down to his little tootsies there. He is 19 inches. And it'll be easy to make a base for him because of the fact that he's got those pegs on his feet. That's what I said. It won't be a problem whatsoever to just make a base for the guy. Overall, I think the kit's worth it. I don't know if it's worth it if you try to find it in the $40 mark. If you find it in the sub-$20 mark and it has all the parts, then it's definitely worth it for a fun display. You could put this together in under, I bet you could put this together in under 2 hours if all you did was glue it and push it together. There is one small part that I forgot to show. This is kind of just an add-on. There's no decals, but you see those things that I just dropped? You see those little spacers in there with the hooks on them, just these parts in the middle. These actually help all the bones snap together so that the skeleton holds together as one piece, and you can move it around and all the bones will stay in place after you glue the front and the back and put the organs in. And then the body has a feature more for the kids that you can actually take this chest plate out, this organ plate, snap that off. And you can take all the guts out and put it back in, just like you did with the Visible Man, Visible Woman. And the entire body goes together really nicely. The pins are located well. The seams are visible, but it's clear plastic. There's nothing you're going to be able to do about those seams, no matter how good you glue it. They're always going to be visible, highly visible, and that's fine. People expect that in a clear kit like this. And then, of course, you got the, you know, look at him. He's looking right at you. He can see you. You're just kind of sitting there watching him, and he's watching you. So anyways, cool kit for the price. I definitely got a deal on it for 99 cents plus shipping. Even without the base, I'll just make my own. I think it's going to be a fun kit. If you like the quirky stuff like I do, go ahead and get it. Otherwise, you can pass on it. There's nothing special about it whatsoever. It's just a little addition to the collection, and will look neat on display. And I appreciate you guys watching the video.